So welcome back, students. Now we will discuss an important question which is actually related to the concept of speed, distance and time, but it is related to the burning of candles. So read the question first of all. This is denoted by question number 29 in our assignment. Two candles of same height are lighted together. Means both the candles have the same height. All in these types of question, always draw the diagram to make it inside in your brain. First of all, you have to draw a diagram only. This is candle one. This is candle two. Two candles are there. And their heights are same. So put them on the same level. Their heights must also be same. So two candles of same heights are lighted together. They are lighted together. They start burning together. First candle burns out completely in 4 hours. This is first candle. C1 is the first candle. It burns out completely in 4 hours. It takes 4 hours to burn it completely. Its length is L. And what is the length of second? It is also L. Why? Both have the same heights. And candle C1 takes 4 hours to burn. So what is the speed of burning in candle one? It is written that in 4 hours, candle one burns out completely. In 1 hour, we know that speed equals to distance upon time. The distance traveled by body per unit time is called speed. So this body is the speed of burning. In 4 hours, length of candle burnt out is given. And it is L. So in 1 hour, what will be the length of candle burnt out? It will be L by 4. This is I have told you to discuss only. This is not the solution. While this is written while. Second burns out completely in 3 hours. So in 1 hour, length of second candle, this is first candle. Second candle that burns out is L by 3. Assume that both candles burn with their constant speed. With their constant speed doesn't mean that they are burning with the same speed. With their constant speed means this is burning with its constant speed and this is burning with its constant speed. It doesn't happen that the speed of burning changes for a single candle. They both are burning with their constant speed. Find after what time first becomes half in length of the other. Find after what time first becomes half in length of the other. So, for after what time first becomes half in the length of the other. So, if after we assume that after x hours, first becomes half the length of other. After x hours. So we assume that, let's assume that. What we have to find? After what time first becomes half the length of other? After x hours. First becomes half of other. After x hours, first becomes half in length of the other. So what will be the length which has been burnt in x hours? Means first of all, what should we assume? Now after reading this question, what should we assume? The initial length. Let the, as they are equal in length initially, let the initial length of both candle be L centimeter. So in 4 hours, length of candle one that burns out is L centimeter as it is completely burnt out. So in 1 hour, it will burn only N by 4 centimeters. So this is the speed of burning of first. So after X hours, what will be the length of first candle? As in 1 hour, it burns by L by 4 centimeter. So in X hours, if you use the same statement again, in X hours, length of first candle burns out equals to L by 4 centimeter per hour it burns into X. That is Lx by 4 centimeter. So candle that left, that remains left after X hours. Remaining, we should write, remaining length of first candle, the total length we have assumed that L. So we subtract this length which has been burnt out in this X hours. That is 4L minus Lx upon 4 centimeter is the remaining length of the candle. Again, in place of I, this time we have taken L. L suits na to the length. So again, for second also we will calculate with the same method. In X hours at both are burning for X hours continuously. So in X hours, length of second candle that burnt out equals to what? As in 1 hour we have calculated, second candle burns out by L by 3 centimeter. So in X hours, L by 3 into X centimeter. So it will be the length of candle that burnt out becomes Lx by 3 centimeter. So remaining length of second candle, what will be the remaining length of second candle? As the total length was L and Lx by 3 has been burnt off. When we take 3 as the LCM, 3L minus Lx by 3 centimeter. Now, according to question, what is written in the question? Read it. According to question, it is written that first candle becomes half in length of the other, means length of first candle becomes half the length of second candle. It is given that after X hours, length of X hours, length of first candle is equal to half the length of second candle. What we have done only, we have written the conditions which are given in the question. Length of first candle after X hours was 4L minus Lx by 4. Half into length of the second candle is 3L minus Lx upon 3. When we take L common, L into 4 minus X upon 4 equals to, it becomes, L is common in this also, 3 minus X upon 2, 3 just 6, the denominator. L will be cancelled out from both sides. 4 minus X upon 4 equals to 3 minus X upon 6. So this L was useless. It has been cancelled out. The calculation is independent of the length of candle finally. As both I have started their journey with the same length. Now, if you open the bracket, 6, 4, 24 minus 6X equals to 4, 3, 12 minus 4X. It implies 24 minus 12 equals to 6X minus 4X. it implies 12 equals to 2x. It implies x equals to 6. So in 6 hours, the first candle becomes half of the second. So continue to solve the sheet. Continue to ask your doubts. Then only you will be able to solve all types of word problems.